Hello everyone, today is 29th of November 2018. This is 9th video about Windows API. In this session, we will create a security descriptor. This session consists of 8 steps. Step 1, we will create 2 security identifiers. In step 1.1, we will create a seed for group everyone. In step 1.2, we will create a seed for group administrators. Then in step 2, we will create ACE access control entries. In step 2.1, we will initialize an ACE for group everyone. In step 2.2, we will initialize an ACE for group administrator. In step 3, we will create a DECL or discretionary access control list, and we will be using set entries in ACL function. In step 4, we will allocate a security descriptor and initialize it. In step 4.1, we will allocate memory for security descriptor. In step 4.2, we will initialize security descriptor. In step 5, we will add a DECL to security descriptor that we created in our previous step. In step 6, we will create a security attribute. Then in step 7, we will use the security attribute to create a registry key. Then in step 8, we will print the allocated resources. For more information, please read these MSDN documentations. In Visual Studio 2015, File, New project, install the templates Visual C++ Win32, console application. Solution name will be Create Security Descriptor Solution. Project name will be Create Security Descriptor. Click OK, click Finish. Include Windows, include IO Stream, include Access Control List API, include Security Descriptor Definition Language, Pragma, Comment, LIB, Advanced API, 32, LIB. Void, Create Security Descriptor. While, 1, Step 1, Create Seeds for Group, Everyone, and Administrators. Step 1.1, Create a seed for group everyone. Seed identifier authority everyone. Security world seed authority. For more information about identifier authority, please refer to this MSDN documentation. We will also use allocate and initialize function. Also refer to this function psid. We will declare PSID here, PSID everyone, null. Then at the end of the block, if PSID everyone, then we have to free the seed, free seed, like this, free seed everyone. Please note that when we allocate security identifier, we have to free using free seed function. If allocate and initialize seed. The first is identifier authority. This is pointer, so we have to provide pointer like this. Authority, everyone. Then we provide 1. Then sub authority should be security, world, RID. RID means relative identifier. Then we have to provide 7 zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then we provide the pointer for seed, PSID everyone. If it fails, then we will display message. I will create 2 functions here, void display error. We will be using string std string message std cout msg error get last error, then std and there. We will overload this function for wstring like this. We overloaded this function. Now we display error, failed to allocate seed for group everyone. Now we break break out of this loop, then it falls down to here. About this function, please refer to this MSDN documentation. So if allocate and initialize seed function fails, it returns value 0. Now step 1.2, create a seed for group administrator. If allocate and initialize seed, we need to provide SID again. SID identify authority administrator. It should be security NT authority. And we create another seed, pseed administrators. And we also have to pre here, if pseed administrator pre-seed, pseed administrator. At this point, authority administrator, then sub-authority count should be 2, security built-in, domain LID. LID means relative identifier, then domain alias LID admins. Then we have to provide 6 zeros, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then PCID administrator. If it fails, display error, failed to allocate seed for group administrators. Break. We finished step 1. 1.1 and 1.2. Now step 2. Step 2, create ACEs. ACE means access control entry. In this step, we will be using explicit access. We will be using this structure, and we use EX explicit access EA. We are creating two explicit access. This structure is used to initialize ACE, access control list. Then we will create a function, template, type name T, size TN, context sphere, size T, arrays, I say array count, T, this is reference, and return n. Okay, I will describe about how to handle arrays in C++ in some future sessions. This function just returns the count of array element count. I will say just element count. Okay, using this, ulong unsigned long ea count ulong element count EA, element count of EA. Sorry, it should be array like this. Step 2.1, create ACE for group everyone. We will be using access mode. Please refer to this MSDN documentation. Then here, EA 0, access mode. Access mode means set access. About access mode, please refer to this MSDN documentation. Set access means indicates access allow ACE structure that allows specified access rights. Then EA 0, access permission, we will set access key read. About key read access permission, please refer to registry key access rights key read. Key read means we are going to give permission to key read, access registry key read. Okay, then EA 0, inheritance, no inheritance. Okay, it means we do not allow inheritance for our ACE access control list. We will not allow inheritance. Then EA 0, do not allow inheritance for our ACE. Trustee form. About trustee, please refer to this MSDN. For example, trustee form, Since we are going to use the seed as our trusty poem, so copy this one. It should be trusty is seed. EA 0 trusty, trusty type should be trusty is well-known group. About trusty poem type, please refer to this MSDN. If you click it, trusty is well-known group. Okay, this is for group everyone. Well-known group. Then here EA 0 trusty, it should be LW LPW PSTR. This is the seed. P seed everyone. Okay. For about these things, please refer to trusty here. For example, if we click this trusty form is seed, click this link. Then if trusty form is trusty is seed, then it should be seed. Okay, let's move on. Now step 2.2, create ACE for group administrators. EA 1, access mode should be set access. EA 1, permission should be key all access. Since this is administrator group, accounts of administrator group can access all keys, have all access about registry keys. EA 1, inheritance, no inheritance. EA 1, trustee, trustee form is trustee is seed. EA 1, trustee, trustee type is trustee is group. Okay, EA, trustee, PTR name, LPWSTR, P seed administrator. This is for ACE for group administrator. Administrator have a key or access. For more about this, please refer to this MSDN documentation. If you click this key, double click it, key or access is here. Okay, it gives all access to permission, give permission to access to all access. Give all access permissions to the registry key. Okay, save. Now step 3, create a DECL. DECL stands for discretionary access control list. We are going to use set entries in ECL function. If set entries in ECL, the first is count of entries, explicit entries. It means we need to provide this, then EA, explicit access, then this is old DECL, it should be null, new DECL, this should be pointer. We have to create P ECL, pointer to ECL, P ECL, we say P DACL, P DECL. And we also free this here, if then local free p decker. Okay, if we read this MSDN documentation here, this MSDN documentation says the pointer to a variable that receives a pointer to new ECL, if the function succeed, you must call local free function. Okay, I will copy this text. So we have to free, we must call local free function for return p decker. Okay, that's why we create using local free. And if it fails, if this function fails, it returns non-zero code. If it succeeds, then it returns error success. Okay, it means successful, but if it is not error success, then it means it is failed. Display error failed to create a DECL with ACEs. ACEs means EA, explicit access. Then we break. Step 4, allocate and initialize a security descriptor. Step 4.1, allocate memory for a security descriptor. So we define here a pointer p security descriptor p PSD absolute. Please note that you should not do this. Should not do security descriptor. Don't do like this, okay? Don't do like this. This is just a void pointer. As you can see, look at the power window. This type def void pointer p void point p security descriptor is just alias for void point type alias for void pointer. Okay, and you should not do like this. I will give the reference. Please leave for these things. Okay. Security p security descriptor is the same as type alias void pointer, and if you want to use point this is please refer to this MSDN documentation. So this is a security descriptor structure. PI security descriptor is the pointer to this structure, but p security descriptor is just type alias. Okay, please understand this point. Now let's move on. Here we allocate p security psd absolute p security descriptor. We are allocating with global alloc allocate gptr. This is size. This should be security descriptor minimum length. Okay, you have to allocate like this. About global allocate, please refer to this MSDN documentation. If we instead of GPTR, we can also, if we refer to this, we can use this key as well, GMEM fixed. Okay, because we don't need to initialize it. This can be a little bit faster because it doesn't initialize the structure. Now save it. We allocated memory. If PSD absolute, it means it is failed to allocate, then display error failed to allocate memory for a security descriptor, then break. This is step 4.1. Now we have to initialize step 4.2.2, initialize the security descriptor. We are using this function, if initialize security descriptor. So we have to provide security descriptor PSD absolute, and we provide revision. This is D word. It should be security descriptor revision. Okay, if this function fails, it returns value 0. So we can do like this, play error failed to initialize the security descriptor, break. Now step 5, add decal to the security descriptor. We have to add decal to our security descriptor. We are going to use set security decal descriptor function. Okay, we are going to use this function, set security descriptor decal. Okay, the first thing is security descriptor PSD absolute security descriptor decal present. Yes, decal should be present. True. P decal pointer to decal. No, this is not pointer to pointer. This is pointer to pointer. This is just pointer. Then default decal defaulted. This term should be false. For more information, please refer to this MSDN documentation. Please refer for more for this documentation. If it fails, it returns 0. If failed, display error failed to add decal to the security descriptor, break. Now step 6, we create security attribute. Create a security attribute. For security attribute structure, please refer to MSDN documentation. The first is the size of this security attribute. The second is security descriptor. And the third is Boolean value for inheritance, inherit handle. Now we create security attribute, SA. Okay, The first is the size of this security attribute itself. The second element is security descriptor p as the absolute security descriptor. The third parameter is inheritance boolean value. We will not make inheritable. We'll make it false. It means it is not inheritable. Okay. Step 7, use the security descriptor we created so far. Okay. We will create a register key here, h key, h sub key. Then we have to close here, if then reg close key, h sub key. Okay. At this point, reg create key.ex. For more information about create key.ex, please refer to this MSDN documentation. The first is h key. It should be h key current user. The next is lp sub key. This is string. We will create my first reg key. Okay, like this. We will create this sub key. Then reserved should be 0. Class, we can provide just empty string, or we can provide something else. Options should be 0. Desired, we will see key read, key write. Okay. Security attribute. This is the security attribute that contains a security descriptor. Please note that security attribute contains a security descriptor. So it should be SA. Then h key result, this is pointer, h sub key. Then dw disposition, d word, dw disposition. Okay, this is the return value, like this. MSDN documentation says if this function succeeds, return value is error success. So if this is not error success, it means failed. Display error. Like this, failed to create subkey, registry subkey, then break. Else means we successfully created std, cout, successfully created registry subkey, std, and there, std, cout. Thank you for watching, std, and there. Please note that we are in while block. We are in while block, so we have to break. We have to break here. Break loop. Okay. Then save. This is step 8. See, this is step 7. This is step 8. Release the allocated resources. Now we call this function. Copied. Paste it here. Control F5. Okay. Successfully created the registry key. Thank you for watching. So let's open registry editor. Start with file explorer, system, windows, here reg edit. Right click, create shortcut here, double click it. Say current user, my first registry key is created here. I will delete this. Please be extremely careful when you deal with registry editor. Now I will run this program again. Control F5. Now it says successfully created register key. Here if we refresh Control F5, you can find our first register key is created. Okay, now I will remove it. Please be extremely careful. Do not delete any key but the key you created by yourself. Do not delete any key but the key you created by yourself. We created this key, so I am deleting it. Like this, okay? Please be extremely careful when you use registry editor. So this way, we successfully created a security descriptor up to this point. Then we created a security attribute to use the security descriptor. Then we used the security descriptor. We released the allocated resources. Sorry, I made a mistake here. We also have to release PSD. Absolute global free PSD absolute Control F5. Okay, it works. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.